Hi there, my name is Jan Porter and I'm at the very first Shimano trade show for the 2010 season. We've got a massive range of products in here and I've cherry picked a few of my favourites and I'm going to show you. But it's far too stuffy in here, it's a beautiful day, there's going to be loads of dealers coming in here, so I'm going to walk outside and show you a little bit more. Well, this is a bit more like it, I'm more in my element out here. A lovely day, I've even had to get in the shade, it's that warm. And I've snaffled a few of what I consider to be the best products at the show. And I'm going to start off with the baby bait runners, which has been a long time coming. I've been sort of hoping we'd launch something of this size for the best part of 10 years, and eventually it's come here. Bait runner is synonymous with Shimano in the specimen world, and now it's going to be widely acceptable, by I feel, in the match angling world for commercial carping, for barbell anglers and also for general purpose pleasure anglers. This is the ST model, it comes in two sizes, 2500 FA and the 4000. It comes with a spool that's fixed already, single handle, and it's in a lovely matte black finish. Slightly higher up the price point, we've got the DL, again in two sizes, 2500 FA and the 4000. And the spool's anodized aluminium, double handle, it's got an extra three ball bearings in there, so it's a lot smoother, and it's an absolute perfect reel if you want to sort of scale down your tackle. A lot of rods now are 9, 11 foot, 12 foot two piece, so it's a real complement to that kind of fishing. A little bit more traditional is the new XTRA, it comes in three sizes, 6000, 8000 and 10000. Slightly upgraded from its predecessor, the GTE, in as much as it's got five shielded bearings which will prevent dust and muck getting in there and ruining the performance. Also got a roller bearing which is full ball bearing equivalent. And for the first time on the bait runner, it's got the ARC spool which has got the chamfered lip which produces smaller coils of line and helps you to cast further and becomes more efficient. Fabulous reel, tried and tested, rear drag, double handle, and you get a spare aluminium spool with each of these. This one here is a special reel as far as I'm concerned. It's not dissimilar to the new baby bait runners, it's a 4000 size reel. This is just one of about a handful of models in the range. This is the D version, it replaces the 3.5, the 4.5 and the 6.5. It's a beautiful made reel. It's got really strong components inside because it's used from the sort of game fishing market. Aluminium spool, again with the chamfered lip. Very, very powerful reel. And I think at a price that barbell anglers and carp anglers who want to fish for floater and stuff like that will find very, very useful. Biomechanical handle, large grip, rear drag for the bait runner. Standard bait runner flick, beautiful reel. And this is something that's a little bit dear to my heart, the Tribal XTA 5500 in a unique Realtree hardwoods green pattern, limited edition. It's a reel that in its Ultegra 5500 and 4500 sizes was our best selling reel for last season. It's become remarkably popular, this size of reel. It's got all the hallmarks of the Ultegra, but as you can see, it's in a beautiful pattern. There's not going to be many of these around, so grab one while stocks last. Comes in a fantastic presentation case, and almost too good to fish with, but if you're not interested in fishing with them, just put them in the loft, save them for a rainy day, and they'll be a sound investment. And I don't really want to forget about my match fishing roots. Back in the day when I used to compete on the circuit, there was nothing quite like this. This is the lightest premium reel on the market, and this will find favour with lots of match anglers, particularly when you float fishing holding the rod in your hand. I mean, what's the point in having an ultra light rod and then sticking a real heavy reel on the end of it? This is made out of CI4, which is a fusion of carbon and polyamide. This weighs 200 grams in the 3000 size, and that's including the shallow spool, so that's 7 ounces in old money. It's an incredibly light reel, and yet it doesn't compromise. It's got all the internal workings you'd expect on a reel at that price. Loads of ball bearings, shielded, anti-rust bearings, comes with a spare spool, front drag, biomechanical handle, absolutely creamy smooth, fantastic reel. And if I got back into match fishing, that's the one I'd be using. Well, since my match fishing days, I've done a bit of globe trotting, and one of the best things that ever came into the Shimano range for me was the Shimano travel concept. Rods that break down into really tiny sections that you can put in a suitcase, or in my case, I put them inside a rucksack, and travel to far-flung places and fish for all types of fish on all different types of techniques. This is the take-apart version. Normally associate travel rods with telescopics, and I've got a couple of those to show you in a moment, but the beauty about these is they're really small sections, and yet there is no compromise whatsoever on the action. They're light, they're crisp. There's a whole range of them in the travel rod series, and they are absolutely beautiful rods to use, and I've accounted for some really big fish on these rods, and I know on some of the heavier versions lads have even taken shark fishing from boats, and a real beautiful product, very popular, and just goes from strength to strength. Traditional telescopic rods used to have a little bit of a bad reputation. Not many rings on them, actions a little bit woeful, really, I think it's the best way to describe them. But the Shimano travel concept rods are light years apart from that. They've got beautiful actions. Even though they're telescopic, they don't give you that sort of threepenny bit effect that you used to get on the old style tellies. Incredibly light, and yet a lot of power in them. Plenty of rings, so you can do a variety of types of fishing, and again we've got lots of different types of actions in those. But my favourite, I've left till last, is this dinky little thing here. It's the telespin, it's a mini telespin. Now look at that, what I would have given for one of those when I was a young nipper fishing down the lean, guesting as we used to call it. I used to have to walk along with a rod stuck out the back here, but that just fits virtually in your inside pocket. And very lightweight, new addition to this one, it actually screws in on the cork handle, and then put over section, and then just in a traditional telescopic way, this rod just pulls out like so. And despite its thinness and despite its lightweight, this is capable of landing really big fish. It's got a tremendous action for casting and also playing fish on relatively light gear. As I say, the whole three of the rods just make a beautiful addition to your fishing collection if you intend to fish abroad, and I don't know where I'd be without them. Well, the cart market is one of the biggest parts of our business, and below the £100 mark, cart rods are volume sellers. And so we've looked into that, and we produced the Katana BX, which is a fantastic looking rod, very understated, minimalistic in terms of the cosmetics, nice new angular style reel seat, split handle, and the Duplon shrink tube on the end there. It's got a lovely matte finish to it, very powerful, but there's two actions in this. You've got a playing action and then a long cast, and the long range version has got 50mm butt rings. The rings in particular are interesting. These are our new low profile, Shimano low profile rings, so actually they look great. They look a titanium effect ring, put over blanks, very powerful, and ideal for anybody who wants to fish from 50 to 100 yards with the right casting capabilities. So a great product, a guaranteed seller, the Katana BX. A couple of new concepts in the Shimano range this year. First up's the Force Master range of commercial rods. This is an entry level range of rods that consists of quiver tip rods and float rods, and there's definitely a vent towards smaller rods now. Two-piece, the quiver tip rods come with two tips, ideal for hardened match anglers on a budget, or just pleasure anglers who like to do a bit of commercial carp fishing. Lovely cosmetics, robust and durable handles, ideal for parrot cage fishing and also for playing big fish on light gear. The different end of the spectrum is a new Purist range. This has been developed in conjunction with the Angling Times Drennan Cup holder Darren Gorder, an up-and-coming young specimen hunter who's really put some big fish on the mat over the last few seasons. This is a 10-rod range. It's quite diverse. Traditional barbel rods and also light specialist rods, but there's dead bait rods in there, very light, ultralight spinning rods, as well as tension bream rods. So you're into fishing in a diverse nature for some bigger fish, and you want a rod that specifically is designed for it, then check out the Purist range, because I think you'll find something there that you really like. We've also got a range of top-end poles, but I'm not really the right person to talk about those things these days, so I'll leave that to Steve Ringer.
Right, thanks, Jan. This year I've got three poles to talk about. They're all in what's called the Gen X range. Now, the Gen X range stands for a compatibility concept, which means all the poles are actually made on the same mandrels. The difference is that the poles are made using different quality carbons, obviously as you go up in price, depending on the model. The first pole I'm going to talk about is the 16-metre Super Ortegra. This sells at £1,150. It comes with six extra top threes, two spare number four sections, cupping kit, plus all the usual benefits. The second pole in the range is the Fireblood. This sells at £2,100, again at 16 metres, but this has got a really impressive package, as in it's got eight extra top threes, two spare number fours, cupping kit, plus the benefits of the hold all, clean cones. So as you can see, that's a really comprehensive package. Lastly, we've got the flagship pole, which is the Aspire Ultra, again at 16 metres, eight extra top threes, two spare number fours, plus the hold-all, as with the Fireblood. So as you can see, we've got three brilliant poles with equally impressive packages. Plus, on top of that, we've got a range of generic spares to fit all three models. So now you can get a top three for, say, a £2,700 pole for as little as £54.99.
Well, that's my pick of the bunch from this year's trade show, but there's loads and loads more tackle to get. And if you want to go online, shimano.com, follow the relevant links, you'll be able to get this catalogue with all the new products for 2010 delivered to your doorstep. So there's loads and loads of stuff in there. Check it out, and I think you'll find something rather nice.